class of 2000, for those that don't know.
Hey, hey, he's good a year now. That's what I'm talking about. Well, that's good. So you did the radio and TV and rehearsal. That gave you some experience.
Right. Okay. And also have an animation degree.
You do? Awesome. Where did you get that?
Westwood.
Westwood College?
Yes, graduated in 2011.
Oh, see? Now we get here. So we got her. We got that. And then you went to Westwood and you got your animation degree in 2011. 2012, you did a film, right?
Yes, I did.
You directed a film.
Yes, I did.
Tell us about that. And that was only part one, but I want to know why there is only part one and not part two.
Well, you have to ask me a part one. But in 2012, I did help us direct a film titled Girls Like Us.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that was the experience that, you know, really got me fire going even more, you know. And that's when I decided, you know, I can do this, you know. I can, you know, create stories. I've been stuck before, so why not, you know, just give it a shot and see how it goes. And if you fail, then take it as a lesson learned. I mean, at least you try. So in 2012, I started writing my first screenplay, the title The Love Betrayal.
Mm-hmm.
But it was like a struggle to like actually get it off the ground. But eventually I did get it off the ground. I learned some lessons and I had some experience along the way. But I can't take all the credit. I mean, I have to give the credit to all of my cast and all of the people that are working with me, you know. Even the ones that were trying to play me, you know, and try to take it away from me, because I see it as, you know, you can't put your trust in everybody. You just gotta, you know, see who's really, really there to, you know, help you bring the vision to life.
Absolutely. Now, you mentioned that you had some struggles along the way with Love Betrayal, right? Meaning that was your first written film, correct? Now, what are some of those struggles? Because I know as people who are starting to do film, beginners, you know, they're going to come across good and bad, some do, who don't. What are some of those struggles that you personally had to overcome to get that film created?
A personal inner struggle that I had, and plus some bad people that didn't really have my best interest at heart, but I stuck with it. I mean, I didn't give up.
Mm-hmm.
There was times where I wanted to walk away.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get me wrong, but, you know, I said, I've come too far, you know, just to, you know, throw all this away. So I'm going to, like, you know, keep on grinding. Whatever happens, you know, just happens. Eventually, I got to come out, but I'm going to do like a reboot of it.
Yeah. Well, don't forget about me when you do the reboot. I'm just saying. I'm here just for the brother.
As good as I can never forget about
you. Okay, there you go. You're speaking some life. But thank you. So, you know, you mentioned that there's some people that try to deter you, try to take you down. I just want to say that haters cannot stop Mr. McFarland. You're on a mission. You did even more work. That brings us to your latest film, right? The Demonic Passion. Oh my God, the name of it, if you want to see what the heck is this movie about, right? But before we talk about it, I actually want to know what made you choose this genre of film, because it's like supernatural with comedy, correct? Okay, what made you want to do this? Because RoboCop is not supernatural with comedy.
Well, it is an action movie, but
yeah.
What got me into the supernatural horror genre, because not everybody is actually known as either like good movies or inspirational movies or, you know, church movies or things like that. And I wanted to, like, you know, put elements of my own life into the supernatural genre. Plus, I love horror films anyway.
Yeah. Absolutely. So when you say you put some of your own life into it, that's why in our intro we say that your supernatural film is actually, you know, is inspired by true events. What in particular that in Demonic Passion that reflects your life in particular? What part of that movie is like?
Well, have you ever had a workplace crush that thought was just, you know, the bomb thing to hear?
No, but that's okay. I can imagine I've never had that.
Well, me personally, you know, I had a, like a fantasy.
get more support from strangers. Because it turns out a lot of people get more support from strangers than they do their own relatives.
Right. More so 75-25 of friends and family and strangers.
Oh, okay. 75 in.
75 in, you know.
Strangers.
Strangers. 25 in. But any support that I get is always appreciated.
Yeah. Awesome. Okay. That's awesome. I mean, I love it. Now, what is your main goal in this industry? Like, what is we are going to let Mr. McFarland leave, because right after